The Sioux Falls Elder Care Channel is brought to you by Tony Mao and the great folks with Right at Home Sioux Falls. Today's guests are Craig Collins and Jennifer Dobler with Compassionate Care Hospice.
Hi, I'm Tony Mao with the Elder Care Channel, and today with me I have Compassionate Care Hospice here in Sioux Falls with Craig Collins and Jennifer Dobler. And so, Craig, I'm just going to ask you to share a few things about Compassionate Care Hospice with us.
Absolutely. We are a national company that has been providing end-of-life care since 1993, and we've been in Sioux Falls since 2004, and then over in Minnesota since 2006. So we have a couple different local offices. The one based out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota, covers 20 counties, ranging from Platte to Esteline, down through Elk Point, and kind of covers everywhere in between there. And then we also have an office over in the Worthington, Minnesota area that currently serves 12 counties in the southwest part of the state. We serve our clients wherever they consider home to be, and that could be an assisted living, skilled nursing facility, independent living, apartments, private homes, and even the good old family homestead out in the country.
Fabulous. So how about, can you share a little bit about what Compassionate Care does, maybe a little bit differently than others?
Absolutely. Tony, you know, hospice is all that we do. And so each of our clients have their own comprehensive and individualized care plan to meet the specific needs of that patient. The staff at Compassionate Care are committed and invested in their career choice to work in the hospice industry. We all have our own special reasons for doing that. Which means, you know, we do have a low turnover of staff, which leads to a, you know, greater consistency and a stability with visits. You know, we strive to be very responsive to the needs of the patients and families with a new referral and, you know, attempt to make that contact as soon as possible. We do also have a nonprofit foundation which assists many of our families, and we don't deny the care to anybody based on their ability to pay for the service. It is a Medicare service that's considered the Medicare hospice benefit, and it's covered at 100%. We also have a few specialty programs that are really unique to Compassionate Care Hospice called Pulmonary Connections and Cardiac Connections. And I'm going to turn it over to Jennifer here to kind of elaborate a little more on those programs and what they do for patients.
Okay. Thank you, Craig. With our pulmonary connections program and our cardiac connections program, those two programs are specifically designed to keep that patient at home, you know, wherever that home is, keep them at home, keep them comfortable, keep them from being readmitted to the hospital. Though in our elderly population, those two disease processes, the symptoms that are associated with them are typically what is sending those folks to the hospital ER. And we're talking about edema, shortness of breath, anxiety, agitation, just a few of those symptoms, dizziness, those types of things will, you know, cause someone to be fearful or panic and get themselves to the ER. With Compassionate Care Hospice, if you are admitted to hospice on one of those programs, we are going to do everything that we can to manage those symptoms at home so that you're not going to the hospital ER. We have a full-time nurse practitioner who is regularly visiting those patients. We also have a respiratory therapist on staff who is also making visits. With those two programs combined, we have been able to keep a hospital readmission rate under 2% for the lifetime of those programs.
Wow, that's fabulous. And maybe if you could share just a little bit about a typical client that's in your care and what they might expect to receive.
Absolutely. You know, our typical client is in the end stages of a disease process. This is end-of-life care. They have declined further aggressive or curative treatments. They are wanting to stay where they're at and be comfortable. They want to be near their loved ones. Some of our folks have a bucket list, you might say, of things that they still want to accomplish. And being on hospice does not mean that you are going to die right away. We have patients that we've had on for upwards of 3 years. And the sooner that you can come onto hospice and, you know, receive the benefits of the great care that we give, the more time that we have maybe to accomplish something on that bucket list. Maybe one more camping trip. Maybe to see a great granddaughter born. Maybe to go to a wedding. Everyone has, you know, their own reason that they want to live a little bit longer. And so with those two programs, with the pulmonary connections and the cardiac connections, we have been successful with doing that.
Wow, very, very well said. And you know, for those of us that don't know a lot about the hospice process, can you share a little bit about how it works and when they might consider to utilize that service?
Okay. The first thing that we would need is a physician's order to assess. That physician needs to agree that the prospective patient might have 6 months or less to live. At that point, you know, we will get consents signed, get all the paperwork out of the way, and go on with that referral process. Our typical patient is, again, no longer seeking those aggressive or curative treatments. I would like to go over some of the common indicators that we typically see with our hospice patients. And I do have just a little card here that we do give out. So what we're typically seeing in those last, you know, 6 months or so of life is a decline in our overall status despite aggressive treatments, frequent hospitalizations, multiple infections, increasing pain, weakness, fatigue, increasing edema, increasing shortness of breath or hypoxia, changes in mental status and orientation, an increase in sleep, some personality changes or mood changes like anxiety and agitation, possibly some increased difficulty with swallowing and some weight loss, needing more help with our everyday activities, such as cooking a meal or taking a shower. They may be incontinent of bowel or bladder or both. They may have frequent diarrhea or constipation, a decreasing urine output, some increase in skin issues, skin breakdown, and decreased verbalization. So if any of these things are happening, and especially, you know, five or more of them you're seeing in your loved one, this would be a good indicator that they could very well be appropriate for hospice. So give us a call. You know, we would love to be able to support your family and your loved one through that end of life journey.
Well done. And it's, you know, obviously you can help them once they get onto the hospice program, but it really sounds like you can help them get into the program as well. It sounds like you take care of a lot of the necessary steps to get them on board. Can you share with the audience just a good way to get a hold of you, a nice contact information?
Absolutely. Our toll-free number is 866-338-2066.
All right. Well, thanks a lot. For Tony Mao and Jen and Craig here at the Elder Care Channel, we wish you a good day and thank both of you for being with us today.
Thanks
a lot, Tony.